Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can use proxy files to take your high-quality 4K videos from looking like this, super stuttery and hard to play back, to this, super fast, super smooth, like you're cutting through your video clips like butter in Premiere Pro. And to save you time, I've created a proxy file cheat sheet that you can download and will show you the exact settings to use very quickly to immediately get started using proxies in Premiere Pro, as well as how to use proxies with slow motion footage, etc. So I highly recommend downloading this cheat sheet if you want to save a ton of time. It's linked down in the description. Diving right into it then, welcome to Adobe Premiere Pro. And here's a project that I've already imported some footage into and edited, and this is very high quality 4K at 60 frames per second footage that I filmed in 10-bit with my Sony a7S III. And as you can see, it ain't playing back super smooth. Takes a little bit to load, start scrubbing through it. It ain't really playing that well. Yeah, we need some proxies. So let's speed things up. To start, you're gonna wanna go to the project panel down here where your video files are, and you're gonna wanna select all of them. Yes, all of them. It doesn't matter what resolution or frame rate your video files were filmed at. You can select everything by clicking on the first video clip that you've imported, then holding down the shift key and selecting the last video clip. You may need to scroll some to do this, but regardless, just make sure that all your clips are selected. Then you're going to want to right click on your video clips and go to Proxy, Create Proxies. This is going to open up the Create Proxies menu, and here you're going to see that you have a lot of preset options, including H.264 or QuickTime for your format. And then as far as presets go, you have a ton of options here as well. In my testing, if you want the smoothest playback across the widest variety of cameras and computers, as well as a small file size for your proxies, your best bet is going to be to choose QuickTime as your format. And then for preset, you're going to want to select ProRes Low Resolution Proxy. In the past, I recommended using QuickTime with Cineform, but unfortunately, Cineform is not supported by some newer computers, so that's why we're going with ProRes. If you're not seeing these options, that means that you're probably on an earlier version of Premiere Pro, and you can actually watch my earlier Premiere Pro proxy tutorial, which I will link to up in the corner and down in the video description. With these settings selected, make sure that you check this Add Watermark box, because this is going to enable some really cool features whenever you create your proxies, and you definitely want to have this enabled. Lastly, for destination, I would select Next to Original Media in Proxy Folder and press OK. It is now at this point that Adobe is going to begin sending all of these video clips to Adobe Media Encoder to create proxies. And I'm gonna warn you now, this can take a while, especially if you have a lot of video clips. If you're only creating proxies for a few clips, this could be done in a few seconds. But if you're creating proxies for, say, a wedding film where you have hundreds of video clips, Premiere may end up sitting there for 5-10 minutes, sometimes longer, because it has to send all of these video clips to Media Encoder to create the proxies. Regardless, once all these video clips are sent to Adobe Media Encoder, it will automatically begin rendering your proxies, and you can go back to editing in Premiere, because Media Encoder is going to render these proxies in the background and automatically link them to your native video files in Premiere Pro. Once your proxy files are done rendering, this is where things get awesome, because you can go back over here to Premiere Pro, and you're gonna notice some things that are new. As long as you check that Add Watermark box whenever you are creating proxies, any video clips that you created proxies for are gonna have this little proxy icon on the clip. And by default, it's gonna be grayed out in black and white because your proxies are disabled. And you can definitely tell they are disabled because I'm clicking around here and things still aren't playing smoothly. Now, to enable these proxies, you're gonna wanna go up here in the upper right in Premiere and find this Toggle Proxies button. If you do not see this button, go over here on the right to this plus icon, and you will find it here in the button editor, and then drag it down here to where I have it on this strip so that way you can access it. Then press OK and your button will be saved. Next, click on this Toggle Proxies button so it is highlighted, and you're gonna notice that two things just happened in your video. First, on the clip on your timeline, you're gonna notice that this little proxy icon is now lit up blue, which means that the proxy for your video clip is now enabled. And as you can see here, all of these video clips are lit up blue because the proxies are enabled for all of them. In addition, if you look up here at your video clip in the bottom left, you're gonna see that there is a very subtle faint proxy watermark that is now a part of your proxy video clip. And this is a great way for you to be able to tell at a glance whether your proxies are enabled or not, because if Premiere Pro is using your proxy file, you're gonna see this watermark. Now, here's where things get really easy for you, because with these proxies now enabled, you can start to click and drag around and Look at how smooth this is. I'm just clicking and dragging as fast as I want. Things are playing. Click around instantly. Just like butter. Oh, I love it so much. Now, with that said, we do have a few more quick things to talk about, starting with slow motion. Yes, how do you use slow motion footage with proxies? This is a question that you may be wondering if you've watched my previous proxy tutorial video that I made in the past, because in that video, I recommended that you interpret your footage to slow it down, which worked great at the time, but Adobe has recently updated Media Encoder and disabled the ability to interpret your footage, which makes that workflow basically impossible. So here's how you can slow down all of your video footage in Premiere Pro super simply and easily and still have it work well with proxies. And for this tip, I want to give a huge shout out to Chris Olson, who made a video talking about this on YouTube. I will link to his channel down below. To slow down your video clips, you're first going to want to select all of your video clips that are at a higher frame rate than 24 frames per second, because you don't need to slow down 24 frames per second footage. That's already slowed down to the slowest possible speed. So in this case, you're going to want to go down here to your project panel, and under frame rate, you're going to see that I have three clips here that are filmed at 60 frames per second. And if you only have a few clips, you can just click and select them. That's easy to do. But if you have a lot of clips, and especially if you filmed at a lot of different frame rates, you filmed some at 30 and 60 and 120, etc., and you want to make sure that everything is playing back at the proper slow motion, here's how you batch slow motion everything. To start, you're going to want to find all of your video clips that are a certain frame rate. And to do that, you're going to want to go up here to this blank spot in the project panel, right click and select new search bin. That's going to bring up this create search bin dialog box. And then under search, instead of all metadata, you're going to want to go down to frame rate. And then for find, you're going to want to enter the frame rate of your footage that you want to slow down. So for example, if you filmed at 30 frames per second, you would want to search for 29.97, which is the frame rate for 30 FPS. Or if you filmed in 60 frames per second, you would want to enter 59.94. Or if you filmed at 120 frames per second, you would want to enter 119.88. In this case though, because I filmed at 60 frames per second, I'm gonna wanna type in 59.94 and press okay. And that's gonna create a new bin that basically searches through all of your video clips and puts all of them that are 60 frames per second in one bin. What's great is that you can then click on the first video clip, hold shift and select the last one, which you may have to scroll down some depending on how many 60 frames per second clips that you have. Then you can right click on these video clips, and instead of going to modify interpret footage, which you would have done in the past, instead you're going to want to go down here to speed slash duration, and then for speed you're going to want to enter a certain percentage. If you want to slow down your 60 frames per second footage to 24 frames per second, set this percentage to 40. Likewise, if you want to slow down your 30 frames per second footage to 24 frames per second, set your speed to 80%. And if you filmed at 120 frames per second and you want to slow that down, set your percentage to 20%. I realize that's a lot of numbers, but that's why I created my free proxy cheat sheet, which you can still download at the link down in the video description. And that cheat sheet is going to include all these frame rates and numbers and settings, so that way you can easily access them and reference them whenever you need to. Because these clips are 60 frames per second, I've entered 40%, and I'm gonna press okay. And with that, you've now slowed down these video clips to 24 frames per second. And what's great is that if you drag one of these video clips over to the timeline, you're gonna see that it is now significantly slower. Here's the old clip that is plays back at normal, fast speed, and here is that same clip now playing back dramatically slower in the proper slow motion. And what's great is that the proxy file you've made is going to perfectly sync up with the native video file, and it's gonna be in slow motion too. So regardless of when you create proxies, whether you create them at the start of your editing or if you create them halfway through editing because you realize that your computer's getting slow, it doesn't matter. As long as you slow down your footage in this way, you will not need to worry about your proxy frame rate being out of sync with your native video files. It's awesome. Lastly, we have two quick things to talk about in regards to proxies, and the first is a general rule of thumb, and that is if you are color grading your video footage, you are going to want to disable your proxies by hitting this toggle button, because proxies are a much lower quality video file, and anytime you're color grading, you're going to want to be able to see exactly what your footage looks like as it's being colored. So I would highly recommend disabling your proxies and using the native high quality video files when you're color grading. Likewise, if you apply the warp stabilizer effect to your footage to smooth it out, this is also going to disable your proxies proxies automatically. So I would not recommend applying warp stabilizer until you're done with the rest of your video editing, which will keep your editing as fast as possible. Lastly, I've had a lot of people ask me about this in the past, but if you were wondering whether you need to disable your proxies whenever you're ready to export your video, the answer is no. Premiere Pro is smart enough that by default, regardless of whether your proxies are enabled or not with this proxy toggle button selected, whenever you press export on your video, Premiere is going to automatically choose your native video files and use those to export. So you do not need to worry or stress about whether Premiere is accidentally exporting with your proxies. You're good to go. With that, I really hope this video has been helpful to you and helps you edit your videos even faster. Don't forget, I've created that free proxy cheat sheet that you can download at the link down below that's going to save you a ton of time and help you out with all of those percentages and frame rates and settings that we talked about. And in addition, I would love to help you out even more. So I've created a free guide called Edit Videos Like a Pro. And this guide is going to show you some of the most important techniques that took me many years to learn as a video editor. You can download this guide for free at the link down below. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.